I think the screen is visible to you.
Yes, sir. Visible, sir.
Okay. In the VLSI design, we have so many stages. PNR represents the placement and routing. In the physical, it comes under physical design domain. That our design is getting manufactured. That means by the layout is getting done. So for the PNR flow, what is actually for to understand about PNR flow, first we'll consider what is the physical design. Actually, the physical design is we are taking the inputs, that is the netlist which we are getting from our front end teams, and we are transforming them into the layout representation so that it is getting fabricated. As you can see, the input is structural representation. The front end people does this logical synthesis output, and they'll generate a gate level netlist. That is the input. That is one of the input to our physical design, and using that input and other inputs, like we have so many inputs like library files that include technology lifts and timing library files and other inputs. We use that inputs and we transform our design into a layout so that it can be manufactured by the industry. GDS2 is the one of the representation format which is used at the fabrication factory. Considering the PNR flow, as I said, PNR represent to placement and routing. First, to actually place and do all the routings, we have to do a few other steps. Those are like partitioning and floor planning, power plan, these three steps. What comes under partitioning? Okay. As we can see, most of the IC chips or ASICs, they can be of huge blocks. So a single team or a single person can't perform the whole PNR flow for the whole chip. So the partitioning is done of the whole full chip level, and blocks are created. So these blocks are implemented with the help of different teams, and at last they are again assembled. That means placed next, and the connections are done between them. So partitioning is the step of dividing the whole full chip level design into block level designs. The floor plan. What is the floor plan? Even if we are dividing our total full chip into small blocks, we have to know about how much size our block should be, and which orientation and which ratio. That means there are some of the terms which are being used in the floor plan stages, like aspect ratio, which I'll be covering them in the next few minutes. Using that, we'll design our die or block level shapes. After that, we'll go for the power planning stage. What is the requirement of power plan? This I'll be covering in the power plan session. Just I am now going to brief about the power plan. Overall, even if we are designing a chip, if we are providing an input, it is not that finished or that is enough. We have to provide power to overall chip such that every area of the chip is getting proper power. These all are kept in mind, and another power losses are also considered while doing the power plan stages. After that, we go for the placement. Placement means actually when we are getting our netlist, we are transforming the netlist. Netlist is just a logical information, but here we have to get the physical blocks regarding that logical block modules, and we have to place them. These all comes in the placement stages. And the CTS. CTS stands for the clock tree synthesis. In our design, there will be many number of flops which are working for the particular operation which they have been designed. As the every flip-flop requires a clock for their operation, we have to provide clock to overall our block or full chip die. So for that process, we can't give clock like just like that. We have to properly plan such that there won't be any clock delays. And if even if they are having any delays, there should be timing met, and other things are kept in mind. Those are considered while doing the clock tree building. While building the clock tree, if we require any of the adjustments, like if you want to increase the delay or decrease the delay for any things like that, we can go for the repeater insertion. This will be done by the tool when we are performing CTS optimizations. Here the hold fix is mentioned after the repeater insertion. What is the importance of hold fix? Actually, for the when we go for the static timing analysis, we come to know about two types of violations which we can get when we are going for the PNR flow or VLSI implementation. Those are like setup and hold fix. After CTS only, we are going to have our actual clock in our design, so that we do the hold fixes only after the CTS implementation stage. And after that, we go for the routing, like actual laying out the wire connections and everything in our design, so that there is data and power connections, data connections and clock connections are done. Here the PNR flow is splitted. After the routing, it is not enough that our chip is designed. We have to go for timing analysis and everything. After routing, we may have violations. We have to get the actual timing analysis. Depending upon the lengths and widths of our routes, which we have done in the routing stage, we have to get the timing analysis done. After routing stage, we go for the RC extraction, which extracts the resistance and capacitance components of all the interconnects which are being used in the design. And with the help of this RC extraction, which we have done, we are getting actual timing analysis being done. After that, this IR drop analysis is done to estimate the power drops, that is, or voltage drop that we are getting in our design, and we have to rectify those things. Signal integrity analysis. Signal integrity comes to say that even when we are having all the routes are being done and we are not having any violations, if we are not having any violations, there can be a situation like that our data signals which are running parallel may get corrupted. That means our signal or the data, which is, as we know, these are all digital signals which are nothing but voltage levels, they may get affected. For that, we have to also go for the signal integrity analysis. And after that, after the whole routing is actually done, we go for the last level of static timing analysis, where we are going to analyze the setup and hold fixes and errors. And if there are any errors, we have to fix. Again, then even we are going for the LVS and DRC errors. Here I'm going to say about what is LVS, layout versus sim. And DRC is data rule check. Here, LVS, as we are getting a logic versus synthesis, here the logic represents the logical input which we are getting from the front end team, which is the input to our PNR flow. And synthesis means it is the layout, and synthesis is the synthesized input which we got from the front end team. We are comparing these both. Why we have to compare? Even if we have used the same inputs, why we have to compare these things? It is important because while doing the optimizations, the tool does changing of the cells and to get proper optimized outputs. That means, for example, when we are going to use a buffer, it may increase the drive strength so that to meet the timing analysis while doing timing optimizations. So even after we implement whole thing, we have to check for the layout versus synthesis that our layout is not different from the functionality which has been specified in the synthesis input. DRC is the data design rule check. Even we are doing all the layout and these things, while manufacturing, there can be some there are some rules which are being defined by the fabrication process. that we should be following such some things like that, the lengths which we have to maintain, the widths which have to maintain, the gaps which we have to maintain between the metal layers which we are using, and everything. These all comes under a design rule check. And after that, the tape out is done. Tape out is actually what we are giving the GDS output file to the foundry for the manufacturing process. When all these processes, all these stages are successful, then only our chip goes for the tape out stage. Even when we are having any of the issues, we can go to the, we can iterate through the previous stages, and that means we can go back and we have to correct those things, and when we have to come back. That means in our PNR flow, it is not mandatory that we are starting at partitioning and we are finishing at tape out. That's it. To fix the errors and all those things, we can go for the backward stages again so that we can solve the issues again. Now I am going to tell about the floor planning which I have briefed in the previous 5 minutes. What is floor plan? As I said, we are not going to build the whole chip at a time. We are going to partition those whole chip into blocks. Those blocks are positioned on the die, and macros in the blocks. That macros are the analog. When we are designing our blocks, we may have the logical standard cells. Apart from that, we will also have the analog macros and IPs in our design. Those comes under these macros. We have to adjust those all blocks in our die if we are going for the full chip, or if we are in the block level, we have to adjust our macros which are present in our block, and we have to place IO pads, and we have to define the area which we are going for, which is for the standard cells. The placement of standard cells is being done only at the placement stages. At the floor plan level, we'll do the part. After partitioning, we'll go for the layout according to our chip size. And again, we're going to place our blocks considering so many factors, which the floor plan considerations, which we have to, which are affecting the floor plan of our design, I'll be discussing later. First, to understand what is floor plan, I'm going to tell about some of the terminologies used in the floor plan stages. Aspect ratio. Aspect ratio is the ratio of height to the width. Aspect ratio, it can be the aspect ratio for a die, that is full chip level, or at a block level also. Standard cell rows. What are these standard cell rows? When we are going for our design, we won't place our standard cell as it like that. We will be having the particular rows, and we are having the power connections to that rows. We have to place those standard cells in those rows so that they are getting power connections properly, and we can go for the routing. And row utilization factor. What is the row utilization factor? It is how much area we are using for the standard cells. Over the total available area. And congestion. Congestion is one of the important term which we have to consider in the floor plan stages. Congestion is like, it is also a ratio which is defined as total, it is the ratio of total resources required to the total resources available. When the required resources are more than resources available, we can't go for the routing in that area of our chip. Then we can say that there is a congestion in our design at that particular point. Blockages. What are these blockages? To prevent congestion and for routing purposes, sometimes in our design, we may require that our standard cells should not be placed in some of the areas. For such reasons, we can include blockages in our designs so that the proper routing can be done at the upcoming stages. Blockages can be of three types: hot blockages, soft blockages, and partial blockages. As the names say that, we can easily understand hard blockage. Its type is hard, that means it defines that no cells or any standard cells, even during the optimization stage also, they should not be placed in our blockage area. Partial blockage. While performing partial blockage in our design, we are going to specify how much percentage we should allow in that blockage area so that other cells can be placed in our blockage if it is required by the tool. Soft blockage. In the soft blockage, during optimization stage, the tool may place some of the standard cells if required for its optimization in that blockage area. Depending upon our requirement, we have to go for the different type of blockages. Bounds. What are bounds? Bounds are like which tells about placing the cells in a particular area. For example, I'm going to explain like in similar pattern, in a small example, like while there are connections between different type of cells. For example, in our design, there is a module A, which is getting communicated with particular pins, which are presently called the right top corner of our die. So in that situation, even if the optimization stage, if our tool places those module cells in a different location, our routing may be long and there may be losses and timing can't be met. So to achieve timing closures for at that module, we can create a bound for that module and we can place that bound at the required position, that is near the top right corner, which it is having communication with the IO pins at that location, so that when we are going for the routing, there won't be much length required for our routing, and even as the distance is less, our timings can be also improved. Apart from this, there are so many terminologies which are used in the floor planning stage. As this is a demo session, I presented you a less amount of them. Other things are like manufacturing grid, which is the minimum area which our foundry can manufacture, and site, which is the place where it is the smallest cell height and width area. These type of all the terminologies are also used, and some of the terminologies like fly lines, which tells about the connections between the modules in our design, and like. What are the floor planning considerations? When we are going for the floor plan, what we should consider so that our floor plan can be better or it can be the best? Macro placement considerations. When coming to the block level, we may have macros and analog macros or IPs in our design. We should also check, even not in the block level, even for the full chip level also, we may have analog macros which are communicating to the IO pins or other modules in our design. We have to place macros there are some considerations like we have to place macros at the boundaries so that most of the chip area is available for the standard cells. These things are to be considered. IO timing considerations. Our IO timing consideration refers to the placement of IO pins or IO pads which are having communication to our design. We have to place or adjust our IO pads or pins such that the IO pins which are having communication with most of the modules are present near to them, so that there won't be any timing errors for that IO pins. RUF of the bound. Bounds are like, as I said, when we want to place a particular module in a specific location, we can create the bound. And even when we are creating the bound, we have to specify the area. Again, we have to consider how much area is required for placing the particular standard cells of that module in that bound. And we should have some more extra space so that routing can be done for that bound. So we have to also check for the row utilization factor of that bounds. Resource analysis. Here we have to, while defining for the floor plan, defining the floor plan, we have to check for the resources which we are having available. For example, when we are having more number of horizontal resources available, we have to position our floor plan such that it should be in a vertical shape. And these are some of the considerations we have to go for the resource analysis. Keep out margins. are like blockages which we are creating around macros or any standard cells. And IO pins considerations about the shape and size of the IO pins, we have to check and we have to do the floor plan according to that. These are some of the considerations we have to keep in mind when we are doing floor plan. And now I'm going to tell about the power plan. What is a power plan? As per the definition, you can see that we have to create a power structure on the core. Actually, core is the area which is present at the center of the die, where our standard cells and other macros are being getting placed. Around the core area, we'll have the IO pads and IO guides area where our IO pads are being placed. We have to create a power plan, that means a power structure consisting of rings and meshes such that every cell and every macro in our design have a sustainable power for them to operate. Now we can see the power flow in the chip, how the power flows in the chip. This example is given for the full chip level, that is at a die level. We'll be having the VDD and VSS, that is power and ground core pads in our design. These are the main supply inputs for our chip. From these, the power is being distributed into the core rings. Core rings are the metal strips which are present in between the gap between the IO pads and our core region. And from these core regions, core rings, our global mesh is being laid. Our global mesh, as you can see the name mesh, it is a mesh structure. And our global mesh is connected to core rings, and the power flows from the core rings to the global mesh. In some of the designs, we may require that we have to go for the local mesh also. What is the local mesh? There can be some situations that some of our standard cell rows are not getting power due to some of the DRCs and other some phenomenons in the design, so that we have to lay the local mesh, which is optional in the designs. And from the local mesh, the power is going to the follow pins. Actually, what are the follow pins? In our design, when the standard cell side rows are placed, to give the power to the individual cell, we won't go for the individual connections to the cell. We'll directly lay follow pin structures, that is using the lowest metal layer in our design. We'll maintain a whole single metal or in a row wise patterns such that all the side rows are getting power. And if a standard cell is getting placed there, while designing the standard cells, also in the layout session, the layout people who are going to design the physical layout of the standard cells, they make the design such that our power pins to the standard cells are also designed using the lowest metal layer available, so that as our follow pins are at the lowest metal layer and standard cell input power inputs are also at lowest metal layer, the connection will be established while the standard cells are getting placed in the design at the placement stage, and then the power is given to the standard cells. This is the power flow in the chip. As not only to the standard cells, the macros will also get power from the global mesh and the local mesh if necessary, which we are using. What are the terminologies we are using in the power plan stage? In the power plan stage, we will use terminology like power pads. What are the power pads? In a chip level, when we want to get power to our chip, we have to have power pads. That means in a chip, we should so many number of IO pads are surrounded in a rectangle or square shapes according to our power plan design. And in that, some of the pads are dedicated for the power purpose, which are delivering the power to our design. And IO ring, as I said, we'll create a power ring structure around the core of the design, between the gap which is present between the core of the design and the IO pads. And from this ring, we'll maintain the core rings, and then we'll connect for the global mesh and local meshes. When we are going for the block level, we are going to have the PG pins. PG pins are the power and ground pins. which are used to give the power to the block level design. And again, we go over the power stripes. Power stripes are the terminology which we use when we are operating in our design stages, we can draw power stripes in our design if required at particular stages. Set to set distance. It is these set to set distance is defined as the minimum, the distance present between the two similar kind of metal layers. And follow pins. Follow pins are the metal structures which are used to give power to the standard cells. Power plant considerations. What are the considerations which we have to keep in mind when we are going for the power plant design? Current density requirement should be satisfied. While we are designing our chip, we'll be having some of the input specifications, such mentioning the current density, how much we have to maintain in the design, and how much voltage levels should be given to the standard cells. These are all the inputs specifications we get for the power plant. And we have to design and calculate how much number of power rings and how much width of the power rings and meshes, that may be global or local, we have to maintain so that the current density requirements are satisfied. These calculations will be explained in the power plant stages. As this is a demonstration, I'm just giving the brief introduction for all the topics. Effects of routing and die size should be taken care of. Why the routing? We have to consider routing in this stage. As we can see that while doing power plan, also we are saying that we are laying power connections, but we are even when we are laying the power connections, we are going to use the metal layers which are available for the routing stages also. So if a particular metal layer is being used as a power stripe in that area, we can't go and use that same metal layer for the routing purpose, as it may get short circuited with the power stripe. So we should also consider the effects on routing stages, and the die size should be taken care of. Why die size is important? Depending upon the die size, we are going to design our mesh, and we are going to design our mesh and the spacing between the mesh structure, that is the set to set distance. These are all calculated. Voltage drop in the power of ground network should be reduced. Why? If the improper power plant structure is done, then most of our power is dropped in the interconnects and metal stripes area only. So our standard cells may not get the proper power connection, so that our design may operate according to the functionality. So these are all considerations we have to consider while doing power plant stages. Thank you. As this is a demonstration, I prepared for a brief introduction of these topics. Okay. pleasure to having these opportunities.